So as Gustav already introduced, my name is Vesar Tiilikka and I'm working as a product manager in Kemppi, a welding company from Finland. If somebody doesn't know from here, and we have actually Axel from Landwetter here. Landweiler, how is it? Landweiler, yeah. Yeah. And they are our distributor also, so we are also in Iceland through them. And I'm talking about production monitoring and quality control with the WeldEye and in combination with this X8 MIG Welder. So basically I'm here to discuss about a real life example how to utilize Internet of Things, you know, theme in a way to combine welding machines, welding systems and the software. So basically as Mr. Hummer already said about the overall theme about Internet of Things and the digitalization of welding. This is basically a one real life example about that. And you know, just a few words about Kemppi. It's a family owned business, headquarters, and basically almost all of the manufacturing happens in Lahti, Finland. And at the moment we are in basically in the third generation from the family who's in charge. And as said, basically almost every single welding machine manufactured is done in Finland, and we have over 600 employees in 13 different countries, plus 70 and something countries through our distributors. But that's not the main point. Main point today is about these themes. So, you know, welding, there are a lot of legislations, laws, norms, standards in basically behind that. And they are related to the qualification of welding procedures. They are related to the skills of the welders, meaning qualification certificates. And also they are related to the documentation, who did, what they did. It may be an authority requirement, a legislation, or it can be a customer requirement, for example, from the offshore industry. If Shell, BP, you know, an energy company, orders something, you can be sure that they have a lot of different demands for the documentation that the customer needs to fill in when they are manufacturing the things. And basically, this is the background why we started to create this WeldEye solution. We wanted to give some kind of an answer and a tool to ease the pain when trying to manage these things. So that's the background basically. Here is the picture of the X8, and as Gustav said, it's actually located behind that door, so you are able to take a look on the actual machine also later on today. It's a multi-voltage, multi-process welding machine, newest model from Kemppi. And you know, okay, it's a welding machine. It doesn't change anything related to that one. But the key things about that are the, you know, the future-proof technologies. So we are able to connect that to the cloud, collect the information and so on. So that's you know, the biggest things. There are some usability things that you can see from the actual machine, for example, this handgun type of a handle to ease the pain and the torque in the welder's wrist, for example, quite the unique. Also the wire feeder, you are basically, if this is, you know, stable on the power source, this wire feeder, then you are always lifting the spool from the upside, not directly, you know, from the you know, left or right. And if you're using this kind of a hanging boom, then you don't need to try to put it somewhere there, you just, you know, lift it from there. We can take a look. And one thing, a big thing also, is the control pad. So everything handled with this welding machine is done through this device. So all of the welding settings, parameters, they are, you know, managed by using this kind of a remote control that can be connected with the cable or wireless. But I will get back to that one also in a few slides. So that's one part of the full system or full solution that we are talking about today. And then the next part, WeldEye, on the other hand, that's a universal cloud-based solution for managing welding production. And the aim for that is basically to make the everyday life and everyday manual tasks easier for the welding coordinator, the people in welding department, quality department, production department. And we are offering tools for managing welding personnel, welding procedures, VPSs, VPQRs, to collect the welding documentation. We are able to monitor the welding parameters, store them, and we are able to verify also the used heat input values from the welds. And the offering in that part is this one. So we have three different modules. Basic modules for basically for almost every single workshop who needs to handle and manage welding procedures and personnel and qualifications. That's the basic package. And then on top of that, when we actually really connect the cloud-based solution and the welding machine, we are talking about the quality control, where we are managing and controlling that what the welders are doing, what they are welding, and so on. Welding procedure module looks like this. And, you know, I could say that the main point for all of these modules has been that, you know, it should be as easy as possible to use, because we know that the user may not use it every single day. So then, you know, he don't need to always scratch his head that, you know, what should I press next. And basically, you know, customers are just creating these welding procedures in the system. It doesn't matter whether it's the WPS, whether it's the preliminary welding procedure or VPQR, all are handled there. And we are supporting different welding standards, meaning ENISO, AWS, ASME, and also some geographical Australia, New Zealand, Japan, and so on, these different standards. And one thing is that, you know, when creating these WPSs in WeldEye, they can be sent directly to the control pad with all of the pictures and all of the things that are essential for the welder. So no need for paper printouts anymore. The second basic, okay, yeah. Couple of snapshots about the picture. You can see that we are, for example, creating these joint sketches by this tool, where we are basically playing around with these symbols. So if I say it in a crude way, you know, the user doesn't need to even know how to read, but he can still draw the pictures through this system. And the printout of the WPS looks like this. Then the second part of the basic package, personnel and qualifications, we are coordinating welders' certificates, operators' certificates, and also NDT personnel's certificates. So the idea is that, you know, when there is a you know, an institute handling these and certifying welders, then the customer enters the data here. They are able to do all of the 6-month prolongations, 2-year prolongations, and so on through the system quite automatically. And, you know, it sends email alarms to your email, to the user's email, so you don't need to every single day take a look on that, you know, what are now expiring at the moment. In the ENISO standards, we are also generating these approval ranges automatically. So not there is no need for enter every single field manually to the system. And the same way as in the procedure part, we are supporting AWS, ASME, EN ISO standards in this part also. And the certificates, when they are printed out or you know saved as a PDF, they look like this. And when they are added in the system itself, it looks like this, so pretty similar one to one. Then the third module where we are basically connecting to the welding machines, it's called quality control. What it gives to you that, you know, when it's an X8, for example, every single weld is automatically documented. If it's some kind of a other Kemppi machine, or it can be a Fronius machine, it can be an ESAP machine, Megatronic machine, it doesn't matter. We have some tools to connect those also to the system. And then welders are using these kind of smart reader devices, which are then sending the data to the cloud. And the main point is that we are identifying who is the welder, what WPS is he using, what is the project that he is welding on, maybe even the actual weld that he's welding on. We may collect the information that what is the wire, what is the shielding gas, or what is the batch number of the wire, if that's needed. Welder reads that kind of information through the QR codes or barcodes into the system, and he starts to weld. Then everything is basically connected to each other and saved to the cloud-based system. And the data that we're collecting looks like this. So you can see the current measurements from one weld, voltage measurements from one weld, and the, you know, the orange lines, they are the measured values, and these gray ones, they are the WPS minimum and maximum limits. So we can see that, okay, something went wrong with this weld, for example. And, you know, if welder is trying to weld some kind of a weld joint that he doesn't have any qualifications, the system will give an alert already beforehand he's doing it. If he tries to, by a mistake, use wrong welding wire, the system gives a warning also beforehand, so he doesn't then try to use the wrong wire maybe. Heat input verification, that means that the welder gets the information after he has welded to the system, and also the coordinator, the quality manager, whoever is using the cloud end of the system gets the information also. And this is based on the weld length. So we are not able to monitor the manual welding speed when it's just hand which is doing the job basically. So welder is entering the weld length through this device or through this device. And that is used for the calculation. As I said, you know, we are able to use this with any kind of a welding equipment brand. And in addition, it's, you know, collecting also arc time and wire consumption. And, you know, related to today's agenda, with the X8 MIG Welder, we don't need any additional hardware. Everything is inbuilt with that welding machine already. When we are running projects in the system, it looks like this. Here you can see the project tree, in a way, the project structure. And here you can see some weld maps. So who has done the first weld? What was the WPS he was using? What were the filler batches used? How much filler was used per every single weld? And so on. All of that is documented automatically. You don't need to collect that information by using some external inspectors or auditors, for example. And the idea about the, you know, the big picture, the Internet of Things and so on, is that it doesn't matter where you are located. Once you have internet connection, you are able to log in to the WeldEye cloud service. It doesn't either, you know, matter that where are the welding machines located. So this device, smart reader, that's connecting always to the customer's Wi-Fi. X8 is connecting always to the customer's Wi-Fi or with the cable also. And that's basically then sending the data to the WeldEye cloud service. So you can be welding in multiple manufacturing units. It can be site welding on the customer premises whatsoever. Everything is still documented. Everything is always accessible by using this. One thing is that also that, you know, okay, some people are afraid of the cybersecurity things, but you know, nowadays these cloud services, they are run by so huge players that they cannot afford basically to do something wrong. So they have an army on working on the security side. So we don't need to be worried about that. And it's easier, it's cheaper for the customer also if these are run by the cloud and not from the local servers that they need to maintain by themselves. And now as we connect X8 and WeldEye, there are two things which are the, you know, the key points in this. For the first time, at least in Kemppi's history, we have the connectivity inbuilt in the welding system. So it means that you are able to connect it to the cloud services, to WeldEye, maybe some other future services and so on, just by, you know, taking the cable to the welding machine or connecting this pad for the Wi-Fi connection. And the second part is the usability of this itself. You're able to see all of the WPS information. You're able to do all of the settings, parameter adjustments, and so on through this. And also, this has a QR code reader here, so welders are able to read the data inside from the project, from the filler batches, and so on. And this combination is then making some benefits, of course, available. You know, the four key points: digital WPS for the welders, productivity things, traceability, and digital work order, which is a brand new thing coming up in actually a few weeks. So digital WPS, what it means is that, you know, somebody creates a welding procedure in the system, and when these X8s are connected to the cloud, within the next 15 minutes, the WPSs are automatically sent to the welding machine. And when the welder is just picking up from the list, from the control pad, the correct WPS, it sets up the welding machine also in the middle of the welding parameters. You can see that if I go outside of the welding, basically minimum or maximum, which are measured or marked with these small green ones here, it gives the feedback instantly to the welder that you are doing something wrong now. Maybe it's not the welder's fault. It may be that, you know, this welding joint cannot be welded with those parameters. So then it's a matter of discussion about the revisioning of the WPS then. And, you know, when you have different welding stations, different materials, you can also decide that what and which WPSs are sent to different welding stations. So you don't have 50 welding procedures in every single welding machine. You can have 10, 5, and so on in their own correct welding stations, basically. The second thing, we are able to measure the productivity figures, meaning that we are collecting all of the welding parameters, all arc on time, wire feed speed, also non-arc time, meaning that the welders are able to report why they are not welding. It may be that due to the layout of the workshop, there is something wrong. They need to always wait for the pieces that they need to weld. Maybe somebody else is using the crane, or they are, you know, grinding because of some unnecessary spatters or something like that. So that can be also reported through this system. And basically, you know, you get the utilization rate of the welding stations, how much arc on time is needed to weld a specific product or a project, and so on. How much did you use filler wire on a daily basis or for a, you know, a specific weld, specific product, specific project. So after the project, you're able to calculate that were you correct when you were making the quotation for that project? And, you know, is there a need for adjustment for the future purposes? Traceability. That means that, you know, we get the welding logs automatically when the welders identify themselves to the system. So you're able to give the documentation for the end customer, for the legislative party or whatsoever, about the products and the projects containing the information, who welded, which weld each welder was welding, which piece, which product, when were they welding it, which WPS they were using, which were the related parameters, and also the information that which was the actual travel speed and heat input for that weld. So no need to collect it anymore manually. Then the last part, as I said, this is the brand new thing, which is coming in few weeks. We also, you know, the first part was that we digitalized the welding specification, digital WPS. Now we are digitalizing the work orders. Basically, it means that the customer is able to send manufacturing tasks for the welders directly to the control pad. They can have their own work queues, basically, in the system, and then they just check that what is the next task that I need to handle. And they can, you know, it can be decided that whether these tasks are sent to specified welders, welding stations, you know, specified welding stations, or to everybody to be picked from the list. And the idea with this one is that, you know, you're able to connect, for example, your ERP system to this, or, you know, manufacturing system. And when you get the order of a specific product to your system, it creates these digital work orders to the WeldEye, and through the WeldEye they are going automatically to the welding stations. And when the welders are selecting the work orders from the list, we get, of course, the working times and arc on times automatically for every single task or a job. So this is pretty unique, and, you know, as said, you know, will be out in a few weeks once we have some software updates for the welding machines. So in a nutshell, this is, you know, what drives us with what is, you know, the future in a way for example, for the manual welding. So as already said a couple of times today by the earlier exhibitors also, that, you know, it's not only about the welding machine, it's all about, you know, connecting different machines to each other, different systems with the manufacturing site to the welding stations and so on. Okay, I thank you. This was my presentation in a nutshell, basically.
standard asks for annual like maintenance and checking of parameters and everything.
Yeah, validation you mean,
yeah,
for the welding machine.
Does Kemppi offer this for...
Yeah, we have a tool which is, you know, it's not directly connected to the WeldEye, but it, in a way it's a similar one. We are utilizing the same hardware, for example, but for that.
So you can go with your Kemppi to the dealer and ask him to validate the machine annually.
Yeah, that's correct, yeah. Do you have the ARC validator here in Iceland?
No.
Yeah, but you know, we have that service also available, yeah.
It is one of the things we have to ask for.
Yeah, that's correct, yeah. That's one of the key elements in the quality system source. Yeah. Any other questions?
After you have a quality inspection on your welds, are you able to input it also into the welder, the results of the quality inspection, to trace it, for example, to the wire pads or something if there is a faulty?
Yeah,
or
that.
Or a pad welder.
Yeah.
Or a pad welder.
Yeah. But I'm not a bad
one. I know.
Yeah. Yeah, that is also possible in this quality management system where we run the project. So
okay, so you can add info like results of
the and you will be able to add, you know, for example, the NDT reports as a, you know, PDF, for example, if you want to collect everything onto the same place.
Silly question. Where do you keep the panel, the console?
Well, you know, that depends, of course, that, you know, that how accessible is the welding place. You know, some welders, you know, we have been selling this machine for a little bit more than a year now. And, you know, some welders, you know, they keep it actually on their belt, for example, if they are, you know, inside of some, you know, vessels, for example, or, you know, then it can be kept onto the wire feeder and so on. So that's up to, but this is quite robust. So you are not able to break this either. Of course, if you run over with a truck or something like that, you know, then you may get some results, but you know, it's not broken that easily.
The welder will be able to change the parameters with that equipment?
Yeah. So he can go outside of the welding parameters also. So now when it's on white, now we are on the inside of the welding parameters, and it goes always to the middle points of the WPS when you select the WPS, but he can adjust it like this. But you know, if but you know, it can be also in a way locked. These memory channels are, you know, you're able to set the minimum and a maximum, so the welder is not able to do that either if that's needed. You know, we know that some customers use those locking functions, and you know, some give them welders of freehand, because you know, it's not the, you know, the by default of the welder basically. It may be you know, that the procedure is not capable on handling, you know, the real life cases. Any other questions?
As a challenge in additive manufacturing, not only but mainly the start and the end have to have different parameters.
Yeah.
To be able to withstand the geometry at least.
Yeah.
So is that possible to do there, to change the parameters at the start and
yeah,
the end?
Yeah. Every single, you know, all of the functionalities are inside of this machine. So there are, you know, a lot of different settings.
Right.
Start and stop logics, for example, here. Yeah. All right.
Okay, well, yeah.